Hey everybody, welcome back to Car Room Report. As is the case with most of Sunstar's Platinum Collection models, there's a lot to like about this new 1958 Ford Fairlane 500 convertible they've sent along. Yes, this pre-production sample is big, close to a foot long actually, and it's heavy, with all of the usual hands-on features we'd expect of this breakout lineup, including opening doors, hood and trunk, steerable wheels, spring-loaded suspension, and a few lesser-sized but equally entertaining sub-gizmos like tilting seat backs and posable sun visors. Also true to form, the azure blue and white paint on the long, low casting, possibly their most proportionally correct yet, looks great, and it's dotted with slick trim pieces and photo-etched emblems ranging from the elaborate Fairlane 500 script on the car's nose to the truly sublime photo-etched and tampoed Ford crest. That's tucked neatly into the metal mesh hood scoop. Now that's a sweet detail I might have missed had I not seen it on a real 58 Fairlane first. Out back between the spam can taillights, another wee Fairlane script hangs tough under the lock for the trunk lid, echoing the larger ones riding on the car's sides beneath the tail fins. That's the beauty of these cars and this lineup in general. The basics are great. The chrome on the huge front bumper plays very nicely against the metal honeycomb grille. And though the peg-centered lensing this early sample is wearing, and the parking lamp lenses it's still missing, take away from the image temporarily, a glance at any of the recently released Platinum models put those concerns to rest. Sunstar makes a lot of hay with clever design. The engine detail on the Thunderbird Interceptor Special V8, a 352-cube, 300-horse H-code offering, is done with tight, sharply defined castings for everything, including the ignition wiring and fuel line. Not having to weave actual wires and cable into place means faster, less expensive production, and it's a good bet that the well-placed, as-yet unpainted bits seen here will get a lick of color, possibly a tampo or a decal or two, to make the motor really pop. The interior seems production ready with a carpeted, matted floor and a soft-touch vinyl boot out back. In between, the two-toned seats and door panels are sharp, and the dash has a glittery insert carrying the gauges and radio. My favorite detail here is the ivory-colored, hand-painted knobs on either side of the steering column, and the tiny handles cast into the vent window frames. Faux window frames are in the door tops. Open them for a look at the painted latch assemblies and chromed sill plates. The trunk gets some love too, with a real fabric mat and a removable steely spare tire. Chassis detailing is moderate, with most of the grunt work being done by a sharply defined belly and frame casting. There's an e-brake cable and a good dose of metallized paint for the dual exhaust and transmission, and the freestanding castings for the spring-loaded rear and front suspensions are right at home, next to skinny, well-treaded white-wall tires and turbine wheel covers. It's a good bet that Sunstar will follow their usual MO and offer us a top-up convertible someday soon, as well as a hard top. They'll also work their way through the 58 color catalog and pull out all of the sharp, period-correct paint jobs we could hope for. With a face like this, what's not to love about that? Highly recommended at just under $100.